Hey, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes, sir.
There's two types of nails in the world. There's new nails and old nails. What do you think these are?
Old.
Both. You come over here and look at these. Many of them that are sticking out have circular heads to them. But there are a few nails and they have circular bodies. Those are called wire nails. Are we all paying attention?
Yes.
Okay. Got a lecture on nails.
Sorry.
All right. The nails that have circular heads and circular bodies are called wire nails. They've been machine made, mass produced, a typical 20th century. While on the other hand, there are a few nails that have square bodies and square type heads. And those nails have been hand forged and they are called square nails. Yeah. All right.
Hand forged.
Hand forged.
Yep.
And so when you're looking at those, nobody used those once the machine-made nails came out. They put blacksmiths out of business. If you ever wonder what a blacksmith did, well, when they didn't have anything else to do, they were making bucketfuls of nails and they were selling nails by the sides of them. So this building, these wood pieces here, which are part of the roof that's blown off, some of these is held on with square nails, like there's three square nails right in a row right there. But then someone's tried to keep it from blowing off, and so they put shingles on it, and that's what the round nails were used to hold the shingles onto it. Probably, when it was first put up, it was a wood shingled roof that was attached to this, and this is sort of the frame of that. And when that old wood shingled roof rotted off, then they went to tar paper, which I don't blame them, and now the whole roof's come apart. Mm-hmm. But, so the roof, what do we date the building to? This roof predates probably 1900.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I would say it goes back.
What do you think, Bob?
1880s.
What? 1880s, 1890s.
Could be 1880s, 1890s.
Yeah.
It's one of the problems in that, to get more specific than that, nails don't give you a whole heck of a lot of information.
I think.
And we're standing right now on the foundations. And possibly even part of a foundation or maybe part of a chimney that has collapsed off over to that side of it. So, guess what we need to measure now?
Yes,
we need to measure the foundation of this structure here. What we can do is just do one right down the middle and then one right down this end of it. And then I need to measure and see how much of a gap there was between the two of them.
Okay. Up there?
It's not a house, it's just a
I'm guessing this one was about 5.3 long this way. Hang on, Kay.
Fuller, what are you measuring?
I'm measuring the length of the destroyed or missing half of the dog trot. So that was 5.3.
When is the moral equipment?
No, I'm still.
I was laying on Mr. Dollar's house.